Okay. Any doubling of the percentage of carbon dioxide in the air would raise the temperature of the Earth's surface by 4 degrees. Any guesses who said this and when? Doesn't sound like something that a modern day climate skeptic would say. In fact, it sounds more in line with something that a present day climate scientist would say. But this was in fact said all the way back in 1908 by Arrhenius. And the surprising thing is that despite the limited knowledge of the field at the time and some uncertainty and errors in his calculation, this estimate falls within the current range of estimates made by modern day sophisticated state-of-the-art Earth system models. So ever since the early attempts at climate modeling made by Arrhenius back in the 1908, climate scientists have been asking the three main questions. The first, has fossil fuel burning increased atmospheric CO2 concentrations? And since we've been monitoring atmospheric CO2 concentrations since 1980, we see that yes, CO2 concentrations have been steadily increasing and have suddenly reached 400 parts per million. And the second question is, have these elevated CO2 levels warmed the planet? Since the beginning of the instrumental temperature record in 1850, we see that global mean surface temperatures have increased by approximately, just under 1 degree Celsius. So then the final question is, what will happen in the future? Groups of scientists, teams of scientists around the world, climate scientists, are running very sophisticated Earth system models, which incorporate all the elements of the climate system from the ocean to the atmosphere to the land surface. However, there is some uncertainty associated with the estimates produced by these models due to the representation of subgrid scale processes such as clouds, atmospheric convection, and mixing in the ocean. So what other ways do we have to constrain the estimates of climate sensitivity? And one option that's available to us is to look back into the past. And we can look back into the last time that atmospheric CO2 concentrations were of the order of 400 parts per million. As you can see on this plot here, we have the high resolution measurements from ice cores where we see fluctuations between 100 and 300 parts per million. But it's only when we go back all the way into the early Pliocene, so that's 4 to 5 million years ago, that we actually see estimates of CO2 levels being as high as the 400 ppm we've pushed them up to today. So thanks to numerous scientists, 30 seconds, woo! Thanks to numerous scientists, we have now got a fairly clear idea of what climate was like in the early Pliocene. We know that on average, global mean surface temperatures were 2 to 3 degrees higher than today. Sea level might have been 20 meters higher than today. Very little northern hemisphere ice and small deserts. Thanks. Yeah.